Shall we make a whistle?
Good morning, Meenu.
Good morning, Chinu.
I am so bored. Play with me too.
Shall we play catch and catch?
Okay, Buzz. Let's play catch and catch. Look, Sahil is coming. Hello, Sahil. Will you also play with us?
Hello, everyone. Yes, I will play with you.
Meenu, will you catch us?
Okay, start running now. I will catch you.
Raja, you are out. Sahil, you are out. You are out. I touched your shirt.
Oh my God!
Chinu, what happened?
Meenu, come quickly. Chinu has hurt his head.
Chinu, wait. Let me blow hot air into my dupatta and keep it on your forehead. You will feel better. This will help you feel better.
I am feeling better.
But my head is aching.
Look, it's swelling up.
But it will get better, Buzz. Meenu is blowing hot air onto the cloth and keeping the warm cloth on Chinu's forehead. Now, it will not swell up too much.
I can smell hot puris and potatoes. Grandma has made them. Chinu loves puris. If he eats puris, he will forget about the pain and feel better.
Come, let's all go and eat puris.
Meenu, what are you doing? Why are you blowing hot air to the puri? It is already hot.
I am not blowing hot air into the puri, Buzz. The puri is hot and I am cooling it to eat.
You are cooling it? Just now, you blew air to make your dupatta warm. Now, you say that you are blowing air to make your puri cool. How is it possible, Meenu? Are you a magician?
Meenu is not a magician. You are asking questions just like the foolish King Dullabhatta. So you are also foolish.
But I made you laugh, Chinu. Your pain is gone now. Foolish King Dullabhatta? Who was he? What did he do? I love stories. Chinu, please tell me his story.
Okay. I will tell you the story. But let's first finish our puris and go out. come, I will now tell this story. Once upon a time, there was a king.
His name was Dullabhatta. He was very foolish. He did not know anything. But his minister was very intelligent. His name was Dhimaku. One day the king's soldiers arrested a man and brought him to the court. They said that he was a witch and he could hurt people. They said that they saw him blow both hot and cold air from his mouth. The king asked them as to what they saw. A soldier said that he saw him blow air to warm his hands as it was very cold. He said after some time, they saw him blow air from his mouth to cool his hot cup of tea. The king got very angry and ordered the man to be killed.
But why? What wrong did he do?
The man did not do any wrong. But the king was foolish like you, Buzz. I also know the story. Let me tell you now. Minister Dhimaku looked at the poor thin man. He asked his king to wait for a minute. He ordered a man to bring a hot cup of coffee for the king. And requested the king to drink it immediately. The king blew air from his mouth to cool the coffee and started drinking it. When the king was drinking the coffee, Minister Dhimaku took a peacock feather near the king's eyes. The king got hurt slightly and his eyes started watering. The king then got very angry with his minister.
But immediately, he took the ends off the cloth that he was wearing, blew air into it, and kept it on his eyes. He did that 3 times, and it felt better. At that time, Minister Dhimaku told the king that he was also a witch. If the poor man can be punished, then the king also should be punished. He told King Dullabhatta that he also blew cold air to cool his coffee and warm air to massage his eyes. King Dullabhatta realized his mistake and said sorry to the poor man. He ordered his soldiers to release him.
Oh, what a foolish king! And what an intelligent minister. The minister saved the poor man's life. He would have been killed otherwise.
Meenu, this story is similar to a story that we have in our book. In that story also, a man called Mia Balishte watches a woodcutter blow air to help the fire of his stove burn. Then again, he watches the woodcutter blow air to cool his potato. So, Mia Balishte starts trembling and runs away, thinking that the woodcutter was a ghost.
I have also read this story, Sahil. It was written by Dr. Zakir Hussain.
Dr. Zakir Hussain? Who is he?
Buzz, Dr. Zakir Hussain was the president of our country. He became the 3rd president of India in May 1967. He wrote a lot of stories for children. He wrote Mia Balishte's story also for children.
Maybe Mian Balishtey was foolish to think that the woodcutter was a ghost. But it's funny that people can blow hot air and cold air from their mouths. Oh, look at Grandma. She is also blowing air on her glasses. Grandma, what are you doing? Why are you blowing air? Are you making your glasses hot or cold?
I'm not making my glasses hot or cold. I'm just cleaning it. Look here. When I blow air two or three times on the glasses, it becomes moist and hazy. Now, I will clean it with this cloth.
Oh, Grandma, I am so confused. When you blow air from your mouth, sometimes it is hot and sometimes it is cold. Sometimes it is wet also like this. How is it possible? Do you have water in your mouth now?
No, Buzz. I will tell you how. Look, my glasses are cold. The air I blew from my mouth is warm. This warm air has water vapor. Now, when this warm air touches the cold mirror, the water vapors turn into tiny droplets of water. These tiny droplets of water make the glass moist and hazy.
Oh, just by blowing air from your mouth, you can do so many things. People are like magicians.
Buzz, you want to see more magic? Look, I can blow air and whistle.
So, air from your mouth can make sounds also?
Yes, Buzz, it can. Chinu just whistled with his mouth. But some people play beautiful music with the flute, shehnai, and nadaswaram also.
Oh, now I remember. I have seen it on TV. I have seen people play the flute on TV. Remember, Minu? We went for a wedding last year. Someone was playing the shehnai.
Yes, Buzz. It was my cousin Rima's wedding.
I have seen people playing the nadaswaram. I went for a wedding in Chennai. They were playing nadaswaram there. Buzz, what are you trying to do?
I am trying to whistle, but no sound is coming.
Oh, Buzz, let's make a whistle for you. Get a leaf and I will make a whistle for you.
Here, Chinu. I have got a leaf.
Now blow air into it. See, you can also whistle now.
I can whistle. Sahil, what are you whistling with?
It is a pen cap. I like to whistle with it.
Look, I can whistle with the toffee wrapper. It has a different sound.
Hey, this is fun. We can whistle with so many things.
Yes, Buzz. We can whistle with so many things. We can do so many things by blowing air also. Look, I can blow air and make a balloon fat.
Just watch this.
Oh no, Meenu. Look at Sahil. His chest is coming out or going in every time he breathes. What happened? Is he fine?
He is fine, Buzz. That is what happens when we breathe in or out. I will show you how. Just get that thread that is lying there.
Here, Meenu, I got the thread.
Just watch me, Buzz. I will tell you. Whenever I breathe in, my chest expands. Every time I breathe out, my chest contracts. This is what happens to everyone when they breathe in and out.
Okay, let me measure it with the thread. Chinu, take a deep breath in. I have measured your chest. I will mark this place with a pen. Now breathe out. Let me measure your chest now. Oh, it was more when you breathed in.
I told you that. Our chest expands when we breathe air in.
Chinu, when I went close to your chest, to measure with the thread, I heard a dhug-dhug sound in your chest. What is that?
Hey, Buzz! Your ears are very sharp.
That's the sound that comes from our chest. You have seen our doctor auntie's stethoscope. She uses that to listen to that sound. Chinu, I know to make one. Let us make one and listen to our dhug dhug sound.
How will you make it, Sahil?
Just watch me. First, I need this rubber tube.
I will measure it from my shoulder to my elbow and cut the rest. Buzz, will you get me a funnel from inside? Now, I will fix this funnel on one end of the tube.
What do you have to do now?
I will just place the funnel end on the left side of my chest. The other end, I will keep it to my ear.
Shh! Quiet now! I can hear my dhug dhug.
Sahil, please give it to me. I will also hear my heart doing dhug dhug.
Yes,
I can hear it. Friends, you can also make a stethoscope like this and hear the sound from your chest.
Chinu, can I also hear the sound from my chest?
Oh, Buzz, this is too big for you. You are very tiny. I will make a whistle for you to play with. Friends, will you also make a whistle with me? Buzz, if you want a whistle, you have to get me a piece of paper.
Okay, I will get your paper. But how big a paper should I get?
Get me a paper that is 10 centimeters long and 5 centimeters wide.
Oh, Meenu, will you help me measure the paper?
Okay, Buzz. Come, let's measure this paper. Centimeters long and 5 centimeters wide. Here, give it to Chinu.
Chinu, I have the paper. Now, can you please make my whistle?
Thank you, Buzz. Now, let me make your whistle. First, I will fold the paper into half. Now let me tear off a small part in the center to make a little hole. Then I will fold the paper upwards from both the sides. Your whistle is ready, Buzz. You can blow into it.
How do I blow, Chinu? You have to teach me.
Okay. Hold the paper between your fingers and put it in your mouth and blow. Wait, Buzz. You can hold the paper with your antonym.
I can blow the whistle. My whistle is blowing. Friends, did you also make your whistle? Is it louder than mine? You can blow gently and also blow hard. It will make different sounds. Chinu, this whistle is really good. I like blowing air also. It is lots of fun. Can you make one more whistle for me to blow air?
No, Buzz. You just blow air with the whistle.
Children, come here. I will teach you to make a fun snake.
A fun snake, Grandma? Please teach us.
Let's make it now.
Children, will you also make a fun snake with us? You can take the help of any elder to make it. Okay, now, let's start making it. Chinu, will you get me a paper?
Okay, Grandma.
Here is the paper.
I just want a round paper which is 14 centimeters wide. Will you cut it for me?
A 14 centimeters round paper? How to measure it? How can we get a 14 centimeters wide round paper?
Buzz, you forgot. We have to use the compass for it. Let me take out my compass from my geometry box. Now, I will measure 7 centimeters with the scale.
Why 7 centimeters, Meenu? Grandma said 14 centimeters.
Buzz, she said that the whole round paper has to be 14 centimeters wide. So when we measure with the compass, we have to take half of it. Half of 14 is 7. So, 7 centimeters. Now when we draw a circle with it, the full circle will be 14 centimeters wide.
Oh, now I remember. This 7 centimeters is called the radius of the circle. Now I understood. Okay, Meenu, you can draw the circle and cut it. Here, Grandma, Meenu has made a 14 centimeters wide circle. What will you do with it now?
Now, I will cut this paper like this, like a spiral. Watch me carefully, children. You can also take the help of any elder. Look, my spiral snake is ready. Now, to hold the snake on both the sides, let me tie a thread on both sides. I have tied the threads now. Have you also tied the threads, children? Now, I will draw the eyes and mouth for the snake. Meenu, can you please give me a black pen?
Yes, Grandma. Here it is. Can I please make the eyes and mouth of the snake? The eyes and mouth are ready. Grandma, what do we have to do now?
I will tell you. Look, this is my hot cup of tea. I will hold the snake on top of it. Can you tell me what is happening?
Yes, Grandma. The snake has started moving.
Good, Chinu. Tell me, in which direction it is moving?
It is moving in a clockwise direction. The snake is moving in a clockwise direction.
Chinu, wait. How did you know that it is moving in a clockwise direction?
Just watch it carefully, Buzz. Look, the snake is moving like this. This is the direction in which the clock also moves.
Oh, now I know. It is moving in a clockwise direction.
Yes, children, you are right. When we hold the snake on top of any hot thing, it will move in a clockwise direction. I will show you one more thing. Meenu, just pass me the lamp. Thank you, Meenu. Let me light it up first. Now, I will hold the snake on top of the flame.
Oh yes, Grandma. It is moving in a clockwise direction. I know why the snake moves. When hot air moves up from the lamp or the tea, the snake starts moving.
But now comes the fun part, the magic.
Let us hold this snake under a fan. Come, let's go inside the house. Chinu, please switch the fan on slowly. Meenu. You can hold the snake near different things and get to know the direction of the air. You will know whether air is moving upwards or downwards by watching the movement of the snake.
Thank you, Grandma. This fun snake is really lots of fun. Friends, did you also make your own fun snake? Did you also make your whistle with us? Who can blow the loudest whistle in your class?
Friends, I will play some musical instruments now.
Listen to their sounds very carefully. Then you have to tell me the name of the instrument that I played. Flute, shehnai, nadaswaram. Bean. Saxophone. Conch. Mouth organ. Will you help Parrot to find out whether the following sentences are true or false? We can live without oxygen. False. We breathe faster when we exercise. True. When we breathe in, our chest comes out. True. We can make a cup of tea hotter by blowing air from our mouth into it.
false.
When we breathe out, our chest goes in. True.
Air that comes from our mouth can be hot or cold as compared to the temperature outside.
True.
Will you answer the following questions, friends? You can write the answers in your notebook also. Who was Dr. Zakir Hussain? Dr. Zakir Hussain was the President of India. He became the third President of India in May 1967. He wrote many stories for children. What happens to the hot air that comes out from a hot cup of tea or when a candle burns? Hot air rises up. What happens to the cold air that comes from a fan? Cold air moves down. Pallavi wants to drink coffee, but her cup of coffee is very hot. She tries to cool her coffee by blowing on it. Which would be hotter, Pallavi's coffee or the air that she blows from her mouth? Priyanka is feeling very cold. She keeps blowing air onto her hands. Which would be cooler, Priyanka's hands or the air that she blows from her mouth? Now blow air from your mouth onto your hands. How is the air from your mouth compared to the temperature outside? Hotter or cooler?